SK Mentor asked us to give him ideas on a logo of his, and we came up with a couple. I admit I had lots of fun with this one. And these are the ideas that we came up with. We're gonna jump in on Canva and show you how we created all of these ideas. Join me. Process, we're going to access Canva at www.canva.com, and we're going to search for a blank logo canvas. Our first logo is inspired by the top 15 emerging logo trends, a blog that we got from Adobe Express. I'll link it in the description below so that you can have a look at the 15 trends that are trending right now. And the first one that is gorgeous and beautiful is called ornamental monograms. You're using letters, and with your letters, you're going to create a single logo that creates a decoration. So we're first going to press T for text, and then we're gonna change our font, and we're gonna use my favorite font, which is League Spartan. And then you're going to change the size and make it 200. And then you're going to press S. Next, you're going to go to effects, and we're gonna be using the hollow. And the thickness, you can leave it as 50, that's fine. You're going to duplicate your letter, and you're gonna type K, because we're giving inspiration to SK Mentor. And once you've duplicated your K, I'm going to change my background and give it that nice dark blue, and then change the color and make it gold for both of them. And then I want them to overlap. The letter marks design wants you to create like a symbol so that your customers can remember the symbol. When they see your brand, they can know. That's the point of creating logos. So we're gonna line them up ever so nice and gentle, and this way we know that we're creating a symbol that customers can remember. So I don't like the extra layer of the S, therefore I'm gonna press R for rectangle and create a shape that lines over the S so that it takes it away. So I'm gonna zoom in. My zoom is my best friend on Canva. The first lining up that I'm going to do, I'm going to take this extra shape, move it inside the K, and it hides the S. And next, you're going to put in mentor. So you're going to type, you're going to press T for text. We're going to be using Open Sans Bold for this one, and then move it to the bottom of the page. And then when we're designing, we always want to make sure that it aligns. Therefore, we're going to use our line spaces so that we spread our word or the word nicely so that it aligns with the S and it aligns with the K as well. And this is our first logo. And I just want to show you how you quickly overlap the K and the S the other way around. So all you do, you're going to duplicate the design, then we're going to slightly move our S out of the way, then we move the shape of the rectangle, we move it over in there, and then we move the S back and slide it like that, and then bring it forward. So you're going to go to position or front. That way it overlaps quite nicely, and there's your second design. For this one, I'm going to change the color and make it black. Then I'm going to press rectangle and create a square shape and change the color and make that slightly light gray. Duplicate the shape, change the color, make it black, move it over to the first square and create a nice line. Spot on like that. You're going to press T for text. You're going to change the font and make it an Anton. Change the size and make it 175. And then highlight everything and type capital letter SK. Move your SK in your box like that. You can also space your letters so that they fill the nice box and the space. And then you're going to press T for text to type mentor, and we're going to change the size for this one and make it 65, and then change the font to Alex Brush. This is a very nice handwriting that you could use for your design. So I'm going to change this and make the color a nice bright red, and your second logo looks like that. I love it. It looks beautiful and professional. Then we're going to jump in on our next logo. For this one, we're just going to change the background and make that nice dark blue. Then we're going to press T for text and use our capital letters SK. So we're going to use the Playfit display black, and we're going to change the size and make that as a large size. And then we're going to change the color of this one and make it a sky blue. I love blue. And then we press R for rectangle, and we create a space in between because it's such a beautiful design that I just need to hold it in here for our mentor. We're going to zoom in so we can control the design better. And then it overlaps quite nicely like that. We're going to zoom back out, and we're going to press T for text, and we're going to continue with our Playfit display. We change the color and make it white, and then we type the word mentor, and then we space it nicely so that it flows like that so nicely. And there's your next design. Next, we're gonna go to our next design and change the color of this one. And for just interesting sake, let's go for brown. And then I'm gonna press T for text, and I'm gonna increase the size, and I'm gonna duplicate this and retype K and move it and have it overlay like that, and press T for text. Change to Hatton, not the bold, and type in capital letter mentor. Rotate that and move it this side so that it is a beautiful design. And there's our next design. For the last design, we're going to go for a different color. We're going to make the background black, and then I want to use a leaf. So I'm going to look for a leaf. I found a free one. You just click on it once and you add it. And the name of this leaf is called Abstract Leaf Shape. And it is done by Temp Tackle from Temp Tackles. So it is a free one. You could go find it. When somebody looks at the logo, they can feel nurturing. They can feel coaching. They can feel mentoring. So you're going to nicely align your leaves by duplicating them, zooming in, and we're going to position this by bringing it forward, lining them up like that, and duplicate, line, position, backward. I've used four leaves. I'm going to group them so that they are one and I'm able to move them in unison. Sometimes I feel like all is lost, but I know it's not true. I want to put up all my walls because I'm not in the mood, but then I cut myself off. You just duplicate it on the other side and you do exactly the same. Then you group everything so that you can align it. And the last bit, you're going to include the SK. You're going to press T for text. And we're going to use Hatton for this one, and we're going to use our letters SK. And there's your last logo that you could group, align it. I think my middle name is alignment. You group it, you align it, and it looks beautiful and sophisticated, and somebody feels mentored and looked after when I look at this logo. So the last thing that you do is you're going to download the 2D logos from Canva, and you're going to jump in on Photopea, and you're going to convert them to 3D logos. Once we land on www.photopea.com, we're going to select PSD templates. Get through.
through this. Life is a nuisance, tied up some loose ends. I try to be human, find a solution, my evolution. A place like this, it didn't exist, we made it like this. So you can go pick the bad or the good, got a glass halfway. I know, it's easy.
If this has given you ideas and I've added value, please smash the like button. And please don't forget to subscribe and share the videos. I do appreciate the time that you spend with me, the comments, the love, the super thanks. I really appreciate it. I will see you on our next video.